Hello my fellow gearheads! Quite unexpectedly, I'm here with the RC version of the Le Mans racer that I built as an alternate model of the LEGO TECHNIC Corvette Chevrolet ZR1 42093. I was originally juggling with the idea just to have a small contribution for the instructions for this one, but afterwards I just decided I'm just gonna do something good for you as well and for the community, so you get the instructions for free. So if you're happy for that, hit the thumbs up button. Don't forget to leave a comment as well after you've finished watching the video. And if you are new over here, please hit the subscribe button down below and the notification bell, and that way you do not miss out on any of the future uploaded content. I had to obviously cut out the fake engine just to be able to accommodate the RC electronic components. But on the other hand, look at the sleek lines of this vehicle. The impact on the exterior has been totally minimized, and I actually managed to improve some of the issues that the original model had, like the illegal build of the spoiler wing, which has now been moved a little bit backwards, and that way you can build it without any issues. I as well reinforced the whole front section, so it's much more stable. And the other good thing is that as soon as you put the battery box underneath the hood, you can actually, without any problem, just press the model in here. If you do it without the battery box, of course, it unfortunately collapses underneath your hands, but other than that, it works totally fine. And I kept pretty much all the details that the original version of the car had. The other good news is as well that you don't need any extra parts than the parts that were available in the set, plus the electronic components, which are three in total. Two large motors, one for steering, one for propulsion, and afterwards the battery box that comes, for example, in the LEGO trains and is the smaller and cheaper version, just with only two ports compared to the TECHNIC Smart Hub. You can as well try to build it with the differential, which is totally fine. The car acts and behaves better when cornering, but on the other hand is much slower. So for the sake of having a bit more fun, I just took out the differential and just used the 22 bevel gear, driving directly axle that is connecting the rear wheels together. And here is just a 12 tooth bevel gear from the differential. The profile that is custom created in the Powered Up app, or you can use any other third party app that you would like, but I'm sticking to the official LEGO one, is very, very simple. You just need a vertical slider for the drive and horizontal slider for the steering. The only thing you need to take care of, as usually, is that in the settings you afterwards just have to press that it returns to sensor. And this is the coding canvas for this setup, which is extremely, extremely simple. I'm gonna put as well a print screen so you can inspect it up more closely. And then if you're done with setting up the app, you can easily just control it like so. And I'm gonna show you how the car actually drives in the living room. So I hope I haven't forgotten anything, and right now I guess it's time to get your bricks from the Corvette ready so we can build this one together. I hope you had fun putting this modification of the model together. And if yes, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button. Feel free to leave a comment. And if you are new over here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button down below and as well the notification bell. And until next time, everybody, stay safe, take care, bye bye, and have a lot of fun with this one.